there are three types of turbulence. There is the stationary turbulence, homogeneous turbulence, and isotropic turbulence. For stationary turbulence, it's for situations in which sigma u square, or turbulence intensity just now that you calculated, is relatively constant with time. For example, the same now as an hour ago. That means the turbulence did not change. Not the actual value of wind, but the turbulence intensity does not change with time. When it doesn't change with time, it's called stationary turbulence. So the turbulent nature of the flow is said to be stationary, or it doesn't change with time. This is a common word to use, stationary. Basically, it is invariant with time. It does not change with time when you mention stationary. So the second type of turbulence is homogeneous turbulence. When sigma u square is relatively uniform in space, the same value in one town as in a neighboring town, the flow is said to be homogeneous. So stationary means does not change with time, one sensor. Homogeneous is means that if one location has the same turbulence as another location. But notice Taylor hypothesis. You see, if Taylor hypothesis, we're assuming, remember, it's frozen. So when we assume Taylor hypothesis, means that we are assuming stationary and homogeneous turbulence. And we use that hypothesis quite often for eddy covariance. So that is the assumption of the method. We assume that the turbulence is stationary, frozen. We also assume that it is the same. Then isotropic turbulence, for situations in which the turbulence intensity at any point is the same in all directions. Now, this sigma u here, doesn't mean it has to be sigma u. It can also be for sigma v, sigma w. Okay, this is just an example. For isotropic, means that the longitudinal turbulence is the same as the vertical turbulence, is the same as the lateral turbulence. When the turbulence magnitude is the same, then it can be considered as isotropic turbulence. You can guess from the word here, iso means same, tropic direction, isotropic turbulence. Now, from my experience, sigma u is usually higher. Sigma u may be about 0.15. Sigma v, usually very small, 0.01 meter per second. Sigma w is about 0.0001 meter per second. You see that the order of magnitude is quite large between the three. So isotropic turbulence is not so common. Maybe in certain regions of the atmosphere where the longitudinal turbulence and the lateral turbulence and the vertical turbulence is the same in magnitude. But here, you see that it's clearly not isotropic. At the surface, it's not isotropic. But some methods or some approaches assumes isotropic turbulence. But the implication of assuming it is that these are the same in magnitude, which they rarely are, from my experience.